Well, hello, all you wizards and witches and all you in-betweens. Tonight, I'm going to be talking about poppets. Sometimes they're called baby dolls or doll babies, depending on where you're from. I got these templates off of, you can just Google poppet template, and you can print it up. These are made with felt, and you don't really have to be an expert sewer or anything like that. It's not really important. You know, you're just putting some stitches around it. You're gonna normally stuff these after you get on the it cut out. Now, let me mention, these are normally made with felt fabric, but they don't have to be. You can really make these with any kind of cloth that you have on hand. It's not a big deal. But the easiest way to make these is after you get it cut out and you start to stitch it, you'll start on one side and you're just gonna stitch around. And what you wanna do is stuff as you go along. You know, I will start stitching, stitch, 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 and then I get about over here, and then I will start stuffing the legs and the arms and the center part, and then I'll continue to stitch on around. Now, traditionally, poppets are stuffed with Spanish moss, and if you're lucky enough to have Spanish moss growing in your yard from a tree like I do, it's good. Some people will go to the hobby store and they'll buy some kind of synthetic foam or something. You know, I'm not really big into synthetic stuff, but you know, if you find a need that you have to do something other than Spanish moss, you know, I would get like some grass or some kind of plants and dry them out, you know, and stuff it with something natural, you know, from the earth, not synthetic. Not into that. So anyways, like I said, these are poppets, doll babies, sometimes they're referred to. The hoodoo tradition gets a lot of credit for poppets. But poppets have been found in very, very, very ancient cave dwellings. And so the idea of a poppet goes back probably since we were genetically modified here in this reality. But anyways, that's another story. But anyways, let's see. You have about four types of poppets. You have a spiritual doll, which when if you do a poppet and it's going to be a spiritual doll, it's going to be a vessel for beings that are powerful spirits. You can use them for ancestors and divine beings. This is one way. Another way is helper dolls, and that's where you you draw the energy of their lives into the poppet. Okay, so that's a helper doll. Doll babies represent a certain person. So if you are, for example, in a situation where you need to bind an individual from doing harm to you or someone you love or know, this is where you would create the poppet with this person in mind. And anyways, don't let me skip ahead. Let me get ahead to the fourth one. The next one is effigies. And these can be created to represent yourself. Okay? Now, some of these you can keep as long as you want, and others you're going to want to dispose of as soon as you're finished with your work. Let's see here. So after and as you are stitching your poppet, and as you're stuffing it, you're going to want to be focused on your intent. You know, if you're making this for a certain person, for example, in a binding spell or something like that, every stitch that you put into this, you're thinking of that person as you're stuffing it. You are thinking of that person. And I'll get in a little bit more to that in just a minute. But after you have your poppet sewn together, you're going to want to baptize it. Okay? There are different ways to do it. In the hoodoo tradition, since hoodoo is